haven't any call in the store, and you call in the store, and you curse in the bin, and you press to the bin, and you shoes on your feet, and you post in the paper, and you look, just power of the then you go to fetch a bird, and you fight from the back, and you're passing your time, without ever more, then you're running from the rap, and it's at the window,
at the window,
who's there?
That's right, sing along everyone. The wildly popular Tony Award-winning production of Cabaret is now playing here. Set at the infamous Kit Kat Club, it is where a rowdy ensemble takes the stage nightly to tantalize the crowd and try to leave their life and troubles in the pre-World War II Germany outside. The ringleader of the bunch is the MC at the club, played by Randy Harrison, who I'm lucky enough to sit down with right now. Randy, thank you so much for coming in.
My pleasure. It's good to be here.
Oh my gosh, already I'm ready to get up and start singing with just that little bit. You know, I actually was a little surprised. I went back to see when Cabaret actually started on stage, because we know it's been around forever. It was 1966.
66, yeah.
Which is amazing. It's still so relevant. It still, you know, is something everybody is raving about. When, do you remember the first time you had seen it, or?
I grew up with the film. I don't remember the first time I watched it, but I know all the Fosse imagery is stuck in my head, and Joel Grey, and of course Liza. And then I think the first time I saw it on stage was actually this production in 98, which was the first incarnation of it.
Yeah.
And I saw that a few times during its 6-year run. And I did it in summer stock when I was 18. So I have like all these different Cabaret images in
right.
my head. It's always been there, though. It's part of the popular culture in American theater now, so much.
Absolutely. So was it kind of weird to actually step into the role and do this?
It was just really exciting.
Yeah.
I think when I saw this production, I never even considered myself as like a viable candidate to play the MC, because I mean, I was much, much younger back then.
Yeah.
and then, yeah, it was really exciting. And knowing all the amazing actors who've played it, I'm an actor who like fed on all their performances, and I watched everybody who's ever done it, and it felt like when you know you're stepping into amazing shoes and an amazing role and something that works so well, it's a thrilling process.
I mentioned Liza just a moment ago, and that is kind of, you know, the first thing that pops into my head when I think about Cabaret and I think about the songs, and the songs are so iconic.
Yeah.
It's something, like I said, sing along. We all know it, or at least can, you know, mumble the words in there.
Yeah.
What's kind of like your favorite song, either you sing or someone else sings in the show?
My favorite song that I sing is actually a song that is not in the film, that a lot of people don't know, called I Don't Care Much. That was written for the original show in 66, but then wasn't used, and then was used in like a revival in 89 that Joel Grey did because he wanted to sing a song in the second act, and it's been used in this version. And it's a ballad. It's completely different than anything else that I do in the show, which is usually like very up-tempo group numbers. So it's this ballad, this sort of very sad torch song that I sing near the end of the second act that I love doing. And then I love Cabaret, and I love the way that song fits into the show. I love the way Andrea Goss, who plays our Sally Bowles, does it. It's so devastating and beautiful to watch. The lighting design's amazing. It's like you just need to scream and cheer at the end of it. It's amazing in this show. So I love those two songs.
Oh, and actually, I saw you had tweeted there was like 7 little known facts that people don't really know.
Right, that Kendra have talked about.
Yeah, and one of them was that there's 3 different kind of versions of Cabaret. Like you were saying, maybe you love the film, but there's songs that you're gonna hear if you come out to this play that you never heard of.
Absolutely.
So I love that you mentioned that, because even if you've seen this a million times, come out, see it live on stage, completely different.
It's especially different from the film.
Fosse
very much changed the story. There's lead characters in this play that he had cut out of the film. The film very much kind of depoliticizes it a little bit. So the show is always a revelation when people see it thinking that they know it. They're like, whoa, we didn't realize that, how relevant this was and how current.
Well, yeah, and one of the other things was, as we were saying, it being so relevant, is he was saying he wishes this would seem more outdated, but it does still seem relevant because we are kind of still going through things, and it may not be specific, but we are still trying to maybe escape some of the things going on in life. So I think this film, like I said, is going to be timeless. It's going to be amazing. I can't wait to see you on stage. But while I've got you here, I have to ask you, you know, we're doing this right now, but do you know what you're doing next? Are we going to maybe see you pop back on TV, or?
I don't know. I mean, I'm committed to this through February. So an acting career is very hard to predict beyond that. I directed a web series that we're trying to sell called New York is Dead. That is something that I've started to do. I imagine when I'm finished this, I usually get really tired of one medium after I've done it for a while, and this will be over a year that I've been performing this role. So hopefully I'll be back on camera a bit.
Well, we, of course, fell in love with you in all five seasons of Queer as Folk, and we would love to see you come back and do another role. You know, in another couple seasons, we could fall in love with you again. We'll be following you. We'll be checking you out on stage. But again, thank you so much
thank
for
you,
coming
Tina.
In.
It was a joy.
Oh, absolutely. You can catch Randy Harrison and the rest of the players in Cabaret. The show runs all the way until the 25th. To get your tickets, call 1-800-745-3000 or visit BroadwayInTucson.com.